गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन ऑफ एकेडमी वॉल स्कूल बेमेतरा। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल रीड अबाउट द डिफरेंट योर केमिकल्स एंड द सॉल्ट एंड लाइक योर सोडियम कार्बोनेट एंड सोडियम बाइकार्बोनेट व्हिच आर बीइंग प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम योर कॉमन सॉल्ट। देन वी विल ऑल्सो लर्न अबाउट द ब्लीचिंग पाउडर एंड योर पीओपी, दैट इज योर प्लास्टर ऑफ पैरिस। ओके, दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस part. Okay, so well, at last I will also tell you what is the meaning of the hydrated and anhydrated salt. Well, you should keep your book and copy ready to have the any of the written notes for that. Well, coming to the first part, that is your chemicals prepared from the common salt. I told the one salt in my previous session. Today we will discuss about the sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate, the common name is your washing soda. Let me start the sodium carbonate. Okay, you also write with me. Sodium carbonate, the common name is your washing soda. Washing soda, okay. And the chemical formula of this is Na2CO3 sodium carbonate, 10 molecules of the water. This is called your crystallization, water molecule crystallization, or crystallization of the water molecules. Na2CO3, 10 water. Okay, so first of all, you will learn that how to prepare the sodium carbonate. The method is known as your Solvay's process, and it is also known as soda ammonia process. Let me write down also soda ammonia process. Okay, in this process there are the three steps to prepare your washing soda or your sodium carbonate. The first step is like this: NaCl plus water plus CO2 plus NH3, it will give you your NaHCO3 sodium bicarbonate plus ammonium chloride. This is the first step. Okay, and the second step is the sodium bicarbonate will be heated, NaHCO3, when it will be heated, it will decompose to give you sodium carbonate, Na2CO3 plus carbon dioxide plus water. Okay, and the third step or the final step is crystallization of your sodium carbonate. How it will be crystallized? Na2CO3 plus 10 water, it will give you your Na2CO3, 10 water. Okay, now you see, I will explain you the whole process once again. So this process is known as the Solvay's process, and Solvay is the chemist, and another name is your soda ammonia process or the method. This consists of the three steps. Before going to have the experiment or the activity, you need to have your raw materials. The raw materials are here. First one is the carbon dioxide. How can we get the carbon dioxide? By taking the lime. Your ammonia gas is also required. And next one is the sodium chloride. So now the sodium chloride is to be prepared in its, you can say, the solution, what is known as the brine solution. So you see that this is the brine solution. So ammonia gas and the carbon dioxide gas is passed through the brine solution to prepare your sodium bicarbonate, which is the baking soda. Okay, now the baking soda is again decomposed or heating. Okay, after being heated, it will give you the sodium carbonate, that is your soda S plus your carbon dioxide and water. Okay, and this sodium carbonate is again going through the crystallization process, in which 10 water is added here, and we are getting the sodium carbonate 10 water. So this is the preparation of your sodium carbonate on large scale. Okay, so now we will read the properties of this sodium carbonate. In the properties, you see that you can also write with me. The first one is that it is a transparent solid. Transparent solid. Okay, and it is actually water soluble, water soluble. And third one is it has or possesses cleansing action. Okay, now other properties are like this: when your Na2CO3 10 water is exposed to It will lose 9 molecules of the water and giving you simply Na2CO3 water plus 9 molecules of the water. And similarly, when it will be heated strongly, then it will lose complete 10 molecules of the water. Okay? And it will give you simple Na2CO3 plus your 10 molecules of the water. Right? Other chemical reactions are like this. Na2CO3 plus your hydrochloric acid, it will form your NaCl plus carbon dioxide plus water. And similarly, one more you can write, sodium carbonate plus H2SO4, it will give you Na2SO4, sodium sulfate plus carbon dioxide plus water. Now, I want to explain once again that the properties consist of the physical properties and the chemical properties. In physical properties, your sodium carbonate looks like a transparent solid. Okay, also it is a crystalline also. It is water soluble and it possesses the cleansing action because of the presence of the sodium. Now in the chemical property, you see that when the sodium carbonate is exposed to air, it will lose the 9 molecules of water, giving you only Na2CO3, one water. But when it will be heated strongly, then it will lose complete 10 molecules of the water, giving you simply dry Na2CO3. Then other reactions are sodium carbonate react with hydrochloric acid to form your salt, sodium chloride plus carbon dioxide plus water. And similarly with sulfuric acid, it will give you sodium sulfate plus carbon dioxide plus water. Okay, done. Now you have to know the uses of the sodium carbonate. The first use, that it is used to make your detergent because of the cleansing action, to make the detergent. Okay, and the second one is that sodium carbonate is used to soften the hard water. So write that, to soften hard water, SOFTEN, to soften hard water. And last one is that it is used in textile mill, it is used in the paper. Okay, and some other also chemicals it has been used. So these are the uses of your sodium carbonate. So do remember, I told you the method of the preparation, then the properties, then the uses. And the next one is that I want to explain you about your sodium bicarbonate. How to prepare, again the property, again the uses, you have to remember. In case of the sodium bicarbonate, the preparation method is very simple. You have to repeat the soda ammonia process, in which we take the brine solution, okay, and it is treated with your carbon dioxide and ammonia gas, so that we are getting the sodium carbonate. So up to this you have to write. So I am only rubbing only this much. Here I am changing the sodium bicarbonate, and this is called your baking soda. Write down here, baking soda, and the formula is NaHCO3. Okay, sodium bicarbonate. Again I repeat, the preparation process start with the solvents process or your soda ammonia method, but we do only the first step, because in the first step we are getting the sodium bicarbonate NaHCO3. Then you have to write the properties. If I tell about the properties of this sodium bicarbonate, these are your white crystalline solid. The first one is right, white crystalline. Crystalline means having the geometrical shape. Second one is that sodium bicarbonate is also, you can say that it is sparingly water soluble. Sparingly water soluble. Okay? And the next one is that when the sodium bicarbonate is get heated, it will give you sodium carbonate, carbon dioxide and water. Let me write down, by heating it will give you, write NaHCO3, by heating it will give you sodium carbonate Na2CO3 plus carbon dioxide plus water. Right? So these are the properties of the sodium bicarbonate. which is known as your baking soda. Now the uses. What are the uses of the baking soda? These are the very common things and few things you know that, still you know something more. First one is that it is used as your antacid to get the relief from your acidity. Used as antacid, okay? Second thing, it is used in fire extinguisher, okay? It is also used in making your soft drink or your cold drinks, okay? And your sodium bicarbonate is also used. First one is the antacid, second one is fire extinguisher, third one I have eaten the soft drink or maybe the cold drinks. So these are the few uses of the sodium bicarbonate. These are the very common uses. So you have to remember this. Next one is, after knowing about the sodium bicarbonate, then we have to know about other chemicals. In other chemicals, I will explain you what is the bleaching powder and what is the plaster of the Paris, or in short it is called POP. Okay? So, we start with your bleaching powder. Okay? Bleaching powder, the chemical formula of the bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride, CaOCl2. Calcium oxychloride. So first of all, the preparation of the bleaching powder, and how it will be prepared. It can be prepared when the chlorine gas is passed through your slag line. Let me write down CaOH2 plus Cl2, it will give you calcium oxychloride plus your water. Okay? Calcium oxychloride plus water. Now you see that calcium hydroxide is known as slag lime. When the chlorine gas is passed over the slag lime, we are getting calcium oxychloride, that is the bleaching powder. Okay? This is the very common preparation. So after the preparation of the bleaching powder, it should be tightly packed, otherwise the chlorine gas will be given out and it will be of the no use. So it is to be packed immediately. Next, you have to know about the properties of the bleaching powder. Bleaching powder, if you see, it is the white amorphous powder with strong chlorine smell. Let me write down. It is the white amorphous powder with strong chlorine smell. Okay? Second one is that the bleaching powder has disinfectant property. It can kill the germs, it can kill the bacteria, it can kill the microbes. So you can write that it has disinfectant property, okay? And one more you can write, it is also soluble in water soluble, okay? So now go to the other properties of the bleaching powder is like this. Suppose you take the calcium oxychloride, when it is exposed to air, it absorbs the carbon dioxide and converts into calcium carbonate plus chlorine. Okay? Similarly, calcium oxychloride, when react with your hydrochloric acid, it will form your calcium chloride plus chlorine plus water. Similarly, you can take the example of calcium chloride CaOCl2 plus H2SO4. It will form your calcium sulfate plus chlorine gas plus your water. So these are the few properties of your bleaching powder. Okay? Now you have to write the uses of the bleaching powder. Let me write down the uses of the bleaching powder here. Uses. use of the bleaching powder. As the name says, I told you that it has a disinfectant property. So it is used as disinfectant substance, and due to the sterilizing property also, sterilizing substance, okay, to purify water by killing the germs, okay. And your bleaching powder is also used in many of the ways, like it can use to make insecticide and your weedicide. Insecticide means to kill the insect, and weedicide means to kill the weed. Weed means unwanted plants or the grasses grown in the crop field. Okay, so these are your uses of the bleaching powder, right? And after knowing about the bleaching powder, then we have to know about your calcium sulfate half water, which is known as your plaster of the Paris or POP. So let me start with the POP. POP means your plaster of the Paris, okay? After uses that one, we start with the plaster of Paris. What is the chemical formula? Calcium sulfate, CaSO4, half water. Okay? So it is also called your calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Calcium sulfate hemihydrate, half water. Do remember that one, the chemical formula. Now you see, what is the method of the preparation of the calcium sulfate half water or your plaster of the Paris? In short, it is written POP. POP, okay? So you start with the method of the preparation. Plaster of the Paris is prepared from the gypsum. Do remember that? It is prepared from gypsum. And the chemical formula of the gypsum is your calcium sulfate 2 water. Let me write down the preparation. Calcium sulfate 2 water, okay. When it is heated under strict conditions or controlled conditions, then it will give you calcium sulfate half water, okay, calcium sulfate half water. So when it will be heated under the controlled condition, calcium sulfate 2 water is known as gypsum, right? Plus here it will give you one half water, like this, okay. But when the temperature will be more, let it be the more than 100 degrees Celsius, then it will lose all the water molecules and it will give you the simple CaSO4, which is known as dead bond. It is a hard stone-like or mass-like structure. So let me write down calcium sulfate 2 water. When it will be heated greater than your 100 degrees Celsius, it will give you CaSO4, okay, plus 2 water get removed out. This is called your dead bond. It is a hard mass and there will be no setting, okay? So this is the method of the preparation of your plaster of the Paris. Now come to the properties of the plaster of the Paris. The properties of the plaster of the Paris. It is a white powder and amorphous. And it has the soapy touch, okay. And the plaster of Paris, it is sparingly soluble in water, okay. And other properties are, it is sensitive to sensitive to air and moisture. Air and moisture. It means that when the plaster of the Paris will come in contact with the moisture, it will form your gypsum once again. Let me write down the chemical equation. CaSO4 half water plus 1/2 water, it will give you calcium sulfate 2 water. This is your gypsum and it will form a hard mass like structure. Okay, so these are the properties of your plaster of the Paris or POP. Okay, now we have to know about the uses of the plaster of the Paris. Let me write down the uses of the plaster of the Paris. What are the uses? There are so many uses of the plaster of the Paris. Uses of POP. The first use is that the plaster of the Paris is used in hospital to have the plaster on the broken bones. Okay, it is used as plaster. Used as plaster in hospitals. Second use is that the dentist, they use the plaster of the Paris to design the artificial tooth. Designing artificial tooth. Artificial tooth. Okay. Then it is used as a white cement. Used as white cement. And this is also mixed with other cement. Mixed with cement to delay the setting time. Delay the setting time. This is another use. Next use is that in household, plaster of the Paris is used to make the ceiling or maybe the wall, just like the giving the coating to make ceiling and your wall coating. Okay, and next use is that plaster of the Paris is also used to make the statue or to mold any of the statue. To make statue of anything by molding. Okay, next one is to make dustless chalk. So these are the few uses of the plaster of the Paris, right? Again, I want to read it out. Used as the plaster in the hospitals, doctors are using to make the plaster, to give the plaster on the broken bones. It is used by the dentist to design the artificial tooth. Then it is used as a white cement, and this is also mixed with other cement to delay the setting time. Next one, it is used on the ceiling or maybe the walls for the coating. And it is used to make the statue by the molding. Then it is used to make the dustless chalk. So these all are the uses of your plaster of the Paris. There are some other uses also, but you try to remember these things. These are very common to you. Okay, after knowing about the plaster of the Paris, then the last one is what is your hydrated and anhydrated salt. That I want to explain you. Let me write hydrated and anhydrated salt. So what is the meaning of the hydrated salt? Hydrated salt. Okay. Now you see, if you remember that today I told you about the sodium carbonate and I have written the chemical formula Na2CO3 10 water or sodium carbonate decahydrate. Deca means 10. So what is the meaning of the 10 water? This 10 water is known as water of the crystallization. It means there are the 10 molecules of the water along with the structure of the sodium carbonate. These molecules are known as the water of the crystallization. These molecules of the water is bound in here, the parent molecule with coordinate bond. Do remember, coordinate bond. Coordinate bond. And the presence of the water of the crystallization do not weigh any of the chemicals. Okay, so there are some other examples I can give you. You can take the copper sulfate, CuSO4. It has the 5 molecules of the water crystallization. Similarly, I have already given you the example of the calcium sulfate. It has the 2 molecules of the water as the water of the crystallization. Okay, so these salts are known as hydrated salt. Now the second one is the anhydrated salt. What is the meaning of the anhydrated salt? Just it is the opposite of that one. If the salt had already lost the molecules of the water of the crystallization, that salt is known as anhydrated salt. Anhydrated salt. The salt which are belonging to this category, they do not have the water molecules of the crystallization, they already lost it. For example, you see anhydrated ferrous sulfate, FeSO4. Okay, so today I am going to conclude my session. So before concluding, I want to recapitulate whatever I explained you. Today I started my session with the chemicals prepared from the common salt, and I have taken the example of the sodium carbonate decahydrate. I told you that how to prepare the sodium carbonate, which is the you can say that very common, and the common name is the washing soda. Then I told you the preparation of the sodium bicarbonate, and also I told you the properties and uses of that. Okay, I have written it here, production, properties and uses. I explained. Next one, I told you about other chemicals. Only two I have explained. One is the calcium oxychloride, which is known as the bleaching powder, and another one is calcium sulfate half water, which is known as plaster of the Paris or POP. I have explained you the method of the preparation again, and the properties and the uses. And at last, I told you the meaning of the hydrated and anhydrated salt, giving the examples. So before going to conclude my session, I want to give you the assignment of this session. Please do write down the questions. I am writing it here, and it is compulsory to solve the assignment in a copy. Then you take a pic of that and post it in ERP, and it is compulsory, and this is a part of your PT1. So do remember this. So please write down the questions. Assignment of this session. Question number 1 is, explain the method of the preparing. Explain the methods of preparing sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, 10 water, then your bleaching powder, calcium oxychloride, and your plaster of the Paris, POP. The second question is, write the properties and uses of bleaching powder, and plaster of Paris. Third question, and the last one is, it is given region, plaster of Paris should be stored in a airtight container. Why? So please go through the ERP. This assignment is also uploaded in ERP, and you have to solve it. Okay, this is the part of your PT1. So I think that you will go through that. This is the last session of the lesson 2, that is your acid, base and the salt. Thank you.